baptism and title. But then throughout the week, as I wrestled a little more with this text and as I did some reading, I came across a biblical scholar, similar to you guys, because you are biblical scholars, who said the path to preaching this particular gospel lesson is thorny. The path to preaching this particular gospel lesson is thorny. And I thought, well, what does she mean by that? I already have my sermon title, right? So I wrestled some more with the text, and the more I did that, I quickly realized that she was right. And in one particular reread of this text, I had to explain holy sacrifice. I am the tenant in this parable. I might get an eviction notice. A text like this doesn't get preached without a little discomfort. We can't hear the words without inserting ourselves into this parable. But since experiencing a little discomfort or a lot of discomfort when wrestling or studying scripture is a good thing, one of my New Testament seminary professors used to say that the gospel should comfort the disturbed and disturb the comforter. So let's get a little uncomfortable and talk about how to be a good tenant. How to be a good tenant, excuse me. Biblical scholars have labeled the landowner as God, the vineyard as Israel, the tenants as their religious leaders, the slaves or the servants as prophets, the son as the gospel message of Jesus Christ, his murder as a rejection of that message, and the threat that the kingdom of God will be given to a nation to bring forth fruit as a threat to the church today. I like those interpretations. And to make this a little bit more real, how about we use the tenants as all of us? In your study time, I ask that you go back and reread this gospel and replace the word tenants with me or us. This parable will take on new meaning, I hope, because it will be a little bit more personal. You see, by the scholars, if we buy into that interpretation, it means that our lay ministers, our ministry leaders, our vestry, our clergy, we are responsible for the gospel message of Jesus Christ being proclaimed, being preached, and being practiced. We are responsible for bearing fruit worthy of the kingdom of God. We are responsible for being good tenants. The beauty about the saints is that God gives us all that we need to make this happen. It's very plain in verse 33 of the 21st chapter of Matthew. There was a landowner who planted a vineyard, put a fence around it, dug a wine press in it, and built a watchtower. Then he leased it to the tenants. Saints, when God appoints us to something or assigns us to someone, something, or somewhere, God is the one that plans to seize. God surrounds us with a hedge of protection and security, and God provides what's needed to bear fruits for God's kingdom. You with me? God assigns tenants like you and I to do the tilling, to do the fertilizing, to do the watering, to cultivate God's fruits. So how does one become a good tenant? Any of you ever had tenants before? Yeah? I never had any. But I've heard the stories, some horror stories too. No matter how much you vet someone, or no matter how many background checks you do, a potential tenant, you just never know what you will get, right? I've heard stories like tenants throwing concrete down the drains. I've heard stories of tenants who don't pay. You heard of those? I've heard of tenants who wreak havoc in what they occupy, then pick up and leave and still want to fight for their deposit. Having tenants isn't easy. Even God had problems with tenants. Sometimes I dream of a church, a community, or even a country where we follow the golden rule, and I wonder how differently things would be. Another trait of a good rent on time. Now, this is an important one, right? I'm sure you can imagine that what the outcomes or consequences would be if we don't pay our rent on time. Eviction, right? Y'all know. Many tenants believe that they have a grace period. Perhaps so with God, right? Because God first sends servants and slaves to collect what is owed, and they're beaten, stoned, and killed. Then God sends them more servants or slaves. Now, I wonder about God sometimes. God doesn't send the police, CSI agents, or B-13, but other servants. And the same thing happens again. Then God sends God's son, the heir to the